Hello everyone!
So we spent a few days in Melbourne and we put together a few things that we consider you should know about Melbourne and I'm guessing Australia in general. Prices, transport, things to see, so let's get it started.
Firstly, we'll show you our hotel room, which is £48 per night and is located in the center of Melbourne. But it can get more expensive during events like Australian, like the Australian Open, for example.
So definitely keep an eye out, watch out for offers, book in advance if you can, but it's a good spot to stay at. At least for us, it was a good one, so let's see it.
So we arrived at our hotel. It's called the
Great Southern Hotel.
The Great Southern Hotel, yes.
It feels quite central, like we've been to Melbourne Central, which you might know it if you visit around here, if you have a look on the map. And we walked 21 minutes, it said on Google Maps from there, but it didn't feel like 21 minutes.
No.
And it's, we're super close from the Southern Cross station, which is a massive station around here. So, what I thought it was really cool is that we found it on hotels.com. It's a website that we haven't used before, but we just found. And you get like reward points, which some sort of stamps on your account with every stay, and you get to build up your stamps and you get a free night and things like that. We're gonna tell you more about that when we make a video on it. And like the space is super clean for the money that we paid. It's super decent, it's super central. You can hear though the trams going back and forth, but I feel like that could be some sort of, it's like white noise. I don't think it's gonna be so bad tonight when we go to bed. But yeah, it's nice. So far, so good.
The next stop is Flagstaff Station, William Street. Change here for Route 58.
We walked around Melbourne and then we realized there is a free tram zone. So we realized a bit too late, but it was all right.
So Melbourne has a free zone around the CBD, the Central Business District area, which is the center basically.
Yeah.
And you can see which areas are free because in each station you have a green board that says free zone. And when you go in the tram, you normally need to tap a card. Well, in the free zone, you don't need to tap, but you're gonna be announced two stations before leaving the free zone that you need to tap your card.
So alongside that there is a tram 35, which is aimed for the tourists, and it takes you around many Melbourne's attractions,
and it's a really cool one. It's like an old styled yellow and green one.
Now how does the transport work in Melbourne? There are trams, buses and trains that you can use, and they go alongside with your Mikey card, and they are working at improving, like changing the system, so you will be able to use your normal credit cards, but that wasn't available at the beginning of 2023.
Now for the Mikey card, you can get that on your Android wallet or you can order it online for $6. But be mindful because that might take up to 2 weeks to arrive. So we found it easier to have it on our Android wallet. Unfortunately, they don't do that for iPhones. So if you wanna have it on your iPhone, go and download the PTV app and then you can just have it there.
How much we paid for transport?
So because we were, it depends from area to area, from like zones to zones. And because we were traveling between zone 1 and 2, we paid $4.60 per ride, but then the maximum cap of the day was $9.20, which was a really good price. We're gonna leave a few links in the description for you to check all the fares and things that we've mentioned earlier.
Also, what we noticed is that people are using their bikes a lot and
e-scooters
as well. And what was funny, they are using helmets. There are loads of helmets on the scooter, like the company itself they provide.
Yeah.
Which ones are they?
Lime and Neuron?
Neuron, exactly. Yes.
So you get helmets, you're going to be okay. We're not sure about the fare, so that's something that you should check out. We really liked the fact that we've seen free self-repair bike stations around the city, plus water refill stations. And taxis, they have Uber and Didi taxis, which is, I'm guessing, the equivalent of Uber. Cool, so make sure you check all the links below if you need the information that we've just mentioned, and let's move on to the next one.
For breakfast, Melbourne has so many options available, especially when it comes to coffee. Apparently, Melbourne has the most coffee shops per person in the world, making it the coffee capital of the world. Like, it's wow when I found out.
So make sure you at least try the coffee when you're in Melbourne or Australia, but Melbourne.
Yes, it was the best coffee I had, yeah.
For our breakfast, we searched for a place with good food, but still a place that can keep us on the budget, and we found the corner shop. The food was amazing. So for two breakfast meals and one coffee, we paid $32. There are also other options like McDonald's, where breakfast can start at $5, or something else that we've discovered and really love, or the sushi places that you can find everywhere. This is such a good meal, no matter if you want a snack, breakfast, dinner, or lunch. And the prices do vary. They start from $2.50 to $5 per sushi. I got a few for myself and I paid around $10. That was my lunch. So it was a really, really good deal. So do check places around, have a look on Google, and you're gonna discover what amazing food Australia in general has to offer.
Yes, my mouth is dripping already. Oh wow, I'm hungry. Let's go have something to drink and eat. Good.
Next one. Graffiti lanes. So one of the things to visit in Melbourne are the graffiti lanes. Melbourne is filled with art and lanes and arcades that show the different cultures and just bring the aliveness in the city. So even though there are so many, we've only seen just a few of them. With all these, I think there are around 10, if not even more. Here are a few of the main ones that you can see around. And as you can see, it's an easy walk around, and it's actually a nice walk from one to the other. And on the way, you can stop and grab a drink or a snack. We thought that the center place was actually a good spot for that. And also, maybe you can try happy hour time, which is around 4 p.m. to 7 p.m. Although, as lunchtime, happy hour can get a bit busy too. But these are definitely nice spots to visit. The artwork that you see on the walls, it's definitely worth it.
On our experience was great on these streets. It was lovely. We experienced the art, we saw people painting, which was really great.
Yeah, I do remember we had a chat with one of the people and I said, do you not mind that someone is gonna come the next day and just paint on top? And he said, no. Like, that's the fun of it, I guess. You just throw it, it's gonna be there for maybe a day or two, and then that's it, it's gone.
Yeah, that's the happy there, I suppose.
So if that's something that you like, make sure you check it out.
Yeah.
Next one. A place that we really loved was the Queen Victoria Market.
Yes.
In a way, that place has it all. Like, you can go anytime during the weekdays between 6 a.m. and 3 p.m. for grocery shopping, for clothes shopping, for pets, for book shopping, anything. You think
you find loads of things there. Yes,
but then Wednesday nights are the nights when it gets even cooler.
On Wednesday, between the end of November and March, you can visit the summer night market. So if you're looking for a nice evening out, this can be one of the places. There are so many food places with different cuisines and all sorts of crazy desserts. The prices are decent, but we did spend 100 Australian dollars for our food, drinks and my shalwars. On top of that, they have local artists with live music on the stage. We loved how they celebrated the different cultures as well as the food variety. So it was definitely a fun evening out. So the next spot is the Docklands, which is a modern harbour in Melbourne. The city had a big boom at some point in the 2000s, and because of that it developed a lot, making Melbourne the city it is today. This area was founded in 2000 and it is known for the pedestrian plazas, the contemporary architecture with waterfront dining, the retail, entertainment and apartment buildings. During COVID times, Australia was affected quite a lot, and maybe because of that, some of these businesses are still not open yet.
With all these, we found this place a nice area to visit, and you can catch a lovely sunset from there. Like the colors, sunsets that we've seen in Australia are just amazing.
The sky, the pink sky, the orange, the all the colors combining.
Amazing.
Chinatown. As every big city in the world, Melbourne has its own Chinatown.
We love to see how Melbourne celebrates its cultural diversity, and Ovi was always saying how he feels like Australia is the country for all. Like, you can see it in the percentage.
Yeah, there's around 30% immigrants in Australia.
And the Chinese culture is a big part of it, so we went to see Chinatown.
Chinatown is a great place for a bit of culture change with delicious food that have decent to cheap prices. As well as food shops, you can find sweet shops and markets. We had a great experience trying Mrs. Zan Kitchen, where we created our own soup bowl, and the total price for both of us was 18 Australian dollars.
As we were trying to see how low we can get with our budget on food, we tried another place, Shanghai Village. And the food and the place weren't so good. Like, we thought it would be that sort of experience where you see the place not looking so good, but it has the delicious food. Well, it wasn't the case. Christmas lights. So if you're in around December or the Christmas time in Melbourne, it's such a beautiful period to see the city.
It was weird
to celebrate Christmas when around you it was so warm and sunny, but yeah, it was nice.
There's so many things you could do, from watching projections on buildings to seeing your childhood cartoons come to life at the Disney Meyer windows, to different events at Federation Square, or simply walking around the city and enjoying the decorations. We were so lucky to catch the Gas Brigade fire show at the Crown. This is a free show with 8 fire towers along the Melbourne South Bank that shoot the largest fireballs in the sky.
We got such a Game of Thrones vibe from that show.
Yes, it was like a dragon spitting fire in the sky and you felt the sudden warmth.
Yeah.
On your arms, it was quite a nice experience, to be honest.
So it's definitely a nice period to check. It's nice to catch the fire brigade show if you're there during the summer months. But do check the timings on their website because they do change from month to month.
Yeah.
So if you're around the South Bank, do check it out. It's a nice view, especially at night with all the buildings around. It's beautiful.
State Library of Victoria is one of the oldest public libraries in the world.
And one of the first free ones in the world.
Wow.
So we wanted to visit it and we missed it the first time, so we came back because we really wanted to see it. They close at 6. And we came back because we wanted to see the La Trobe reading room. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that correctly. La Trobe, I'm not sure. That's an octagonal reading room that is 6 floors high and can hold up to 32,000 books and have around 320 readers at its desk. And the best view you get from the top.
So to get there, you need to take a lift that takes you to the 6th floor and from there you can really enjoy the view. But don't forget, you are still in the library and you can't be like, wow, this is amazing. You need to keep quiet because there are people there reading and stuff.
Yeah, beautiful spot though.
Yes.
We hope that you really enjoyed everything that we put together in this video. We hope that it was useful. And if you get to visit Melbourne, definitely do that. We hope you'll enjoy it.
Yes, yes, definitely. So please subscribe, like, and comment something.
Let us know your thoughts. Let us know what you think about Melbourne. Let us know, have you ever tried the coffee here? Like, do you know anything about the coffee or the food?
Yes.
Let us know your thoughts in the comments.
Yes, please let us know in the comments what you think.
Okay, see you next time.
See you.